Hello there. It's time to find out about the Ringed City. Now, I've got the Beefy Boy back from when we did the last DLC. I haven't really done much since we did the last DLC. But I did finish the game, and as I was doing that, I came across what looks to be a new area. So I'm going to go there, because I think that might be the DLC. I spotted this bonfire and I was like, hang on a second. Does this just teleport me back up to the top? And then it took me somewhere else and it was terrifying and I ran away. It wasn't so much that it was scary. I thought it might be the DLC. And if it is the DLC, then I didn't want to get into it until I was ready to stream it. Thank you to Dan, to Nipnops for the host. Much appreciated. Oh, I'm looking forward to this. I have not played Dark Souls 3 in a while. Apart from yesterday, when I played it very briefly just to get a feel for it. So we'll see how it goes. This character seems reasonably decent. So this is the Dreg Heap. I've not seen this before, so I'm guessing it's new. Let's check for those hidden walls. Whoosh! So I got the Zweihänder. It's just a strength build. And I'm not doing anything fancy. In fact, can I see, if I look at this, can I see, like, will it tell me? Huh, it is a new area. It doesn't actually say anything else about it. See, this one says Painted World of Ariandel. This doesn't say anything. But I guess they don't want to spoil what's up ahead, so. Here we are, look at this, Broken World. This kind of, I guess this is... Is this the same area as the final part of the game? Because it kind of looks like it. Got a new... Take the plunge. Okay, well, it sounds like we're going to just jump off then, I guess. What's down here? Is there a bonfire down there? No. I think it was just a flicker of light. Let's take the plunge, I guess. It's not very far. Ah! Okay, that wasn't nearly so bad as I was expecting. Oh, wow, that didn't even take damage from that. Landed this lovely snowdrift. Okay, we can just walk down here. Oh, there's a fellow over there. Oh, hello. Okay, right, it's all kicking off. Okay, whoa, hello. Yeah, they seem aggressive. They seem kind of like the crows from the last DLC, but like maybe a little bit less... Who is doing that? It's you. How do I... Can I get to you? Oh god, that actually does a lot of damage. Hello. I guess if I go up here, I can probably drop down to them? Oh wow, there's stuff going on over here as well. Crikey, it's all kicking off. Hello. There's a big fella. Just getting my bearings here. Let's take a wander down and see what's going on over here. There's a bloke over here. We'll just kind of poise our way through it. Oh god, no! Why did I fall for it? Shit! Oh well. I was like, I'll just grab this item and then we'll go onwards. Oh my god! What the fuck is this? Get off me! This place is a nightmare. There's like a weird, like, ring on the floor. Oh my god! What the shit is this? Oh, a titanite scale. Very nice. This place is terrifying. Also, I've got no health. Damn it! I tried to heal up. Oh wow, okay. They're not messing around. I'll say that much. They're definitely not messing around. And it seems like there's multiple ways we could go. I guess I'll go up first, because it seems like I could come back from there. Wow, okay. Yeah, the Painted World kind of eased you in. It was a fairly sort of chill start. Help me. Why am I getting messages? Oh, actually, I'm not playing offline. I was supposed to be playing offline. But I'm not. I forgot. I forgot that I wasn't playing offline. Can I change it now? Do I have to, like... No. I'd have to leave the game. I don't know if I can be bothered. I'm gonna come back. I'm probably gonna take a break for lunch in an hour or so. So maybe after I've had lunch, I'll play offline. I kind of want to play offline just because I don't want messages to spoil all the hidden areas. Which they're prone to do. Yeah, look at this. It's a good thing these guys seem to have like quite a generous hitbox, because they could be a real pain if they didn't. Also, I wonder how you get to the dude over there, because it doesn't seem like a good way to... There's a dude kind of like here. And I... Maybe if you drop down from there, I guess you could get to him? Or I guess you can just drop down from here. I don't want to fall off the edge. That's the only thing. Falling off enough edges already in this DLC. There, that was the thing they did a little bit in the last one as well. It was like, we're just going to drop you off this edge. Oh, I can't apparently just run around here. Okay, I didn't notice that. Yeah. Have some of that and some of that. Oh. You alive? You are alive. Okay. I wasn't sure. He looked kind of passive. I thought maybe it was going to be someone we could talk to. Right, let's go see this big boy up here. I guess. Yeah, see, look, we are literally, like, this is in the same area as the kiln of the first flame, I guess. Which is, that's cool. This guy's got no head. I wonder if I can backstab him. He's a big dude, though. I can stagger him, apparently, which is nice. I can't backstab him like that, at least. Just back off a sec. Wow. Hello. He's exciting, isn't he? You can usually backstab like even the big dudes in the main game. So I... Oh my god. The butt leap. That's good. I like that. Ow. Jeez, he's a big boy. I guess I shouldn't be surprised that hurts. Seems like you can kind of stagger him a little bit. Okay. I do like this lovely, like, dark sign sun thing. Tight night chunk. On these hidden corners. Well, I guess it's not really a hidden corner, but... I always expect something to be around those blind corners, and there very rarely is, even in the main game. 4 tight night chunks. Well, I guess this is nice, but it is, it, you know, it's end game, so. Jump attack! Oh, I guess, yeah, you could run up here and jump onto him. Sure. Aquamarine dagger. Ooh. Okay. I guess it'll be in here, right? In the... Well, it's probably going to be at the top if it's a dagger. Ah, there it is. Aquamarine dagger. Crystal blade. A dagger fitted with an aquamarine crystal, engraved with a prayer in the old tongue to ward off incident. Perhaps it was a parting gift, given to one sent off on great travels. Okay, so it kind of has the... it's almost like the spell, the sorcery that does the blade. Makes it a little bit longer. That's kind of neat. Huh. It's a light. Huh. Okay. No, nothing doing there. At least not for now. Maybe there is something here. I don't know. But I don't want to... I don't want to read too much into the messages. It's kind of why I don't like having the messages on, because you get kind of hung up on people writing stuff. Let's have a look at... This is very nice design. I always like these weird sideways cities. It's a fun little thing. So I guess we just drop off here now. This thing just broke last time. And where did it sent us down into this like sideways cathedral, I guess. Well, nothing for it. Oh, you actually land inside the weird summoning circle and it just kills the frame rate as well. Which I guess, you know, that's fair enough. So you killed me last time, so I'm having none of that. Seems like these guys, a lot of them only spring up when you get near to them. There is an item there. How do I get to it? Around here. No? Up here? And then over? There we go. Something's behind me. Murky Hand Scythe. Oh, it's you. I was like, there's definitely someone around here. Murky Hand Scythe. Oh, there it is, right on it. A short shafted hand scythe wielded by the Murk Men who rise from the depths. So I guess that's those weird fellas we've been encountering. Enveloped by a black dampness and imbued with the strength of dark, and it has the quick step skill. That's kind of cool. It looks nice. Like a little scythe. And, yeah, physical dark. Not bad, not bad. And we just hop off here. Now, there's a bunch of dudes around here as well, so... There's a guy up on the roof. There's a guy casting over there, so I kind of want to... Oh, dude. I forgot about the big guy. What is that? Is someone casting that? Or is that just like a... Is that actually a thing I can fight? These guys are actually quite hard to see. Which I suppose is kind of by design. Some twinkling titanite from this fallen chandelier. Poor chap. Yeah, take that, telescopes. Who needs astrology anyway? Or astronomy, for that matter. Take the plunge, or I've heard that before. Oh my goodness! Oh, it's an angel! Hello! I guess I could use a sorcery or something. I can't use sorcery. The character doesn't have sorceries. What am I talking about? Just go down. Ow! Ow! Okay. Take it easy. I want to see if there's something over there. Oh, there is. There's an item. It's mine. Yes. Okay. And I guess we can get down there, and then we're probably safe, right? We're never safe. It's Dark Souls. What am I talking about? I wonder if they'll follow us around. Lightning urn. Ooh. Oh, there's a lot going on in here. I'm just going to go check around this corner first. Whew. I like this. This is an intense start. Whoa, hello. Damn it. I saw him coming as well. I don't know if they're supposed to be trying to like drag you into the ground. It kind of looks like it, but I'm a physical being. I can't, you know. Ring ahead. Okay. Well, I do kind of want to go down there. Despite everything. Ow, ow. Ring of steel protection plus 3. I mean, that's not very helpful against this dude, I don't think. Ah, god dang it. I thought I might be able to get away. But we got the ring, which is the important thing. And we can dash back to there. Probably in no time. This is good. It's kind of chaotic, but it seems to be... like more intense off the bat than the last DLC was. So can you drop down here? No, I thought maybe you could drop down onto like where that dude is, but I'm not 100% convinced that you can. This is a cool area, though. Let's have a little look at it. Oh, hello. Oh my god, I didn't even notice you were a person.
Oh, your head's square on your shoulders, is it? I thought that clamoring tin can was the last. But here we go again. What is it you want from this old stone-armed hag? I've nothing for you, not a smithereen. I just like to stand here and take in the view.
I guess I have business with you?
Well, that came out of nowhere. You think an old stone-armed hag would be brimming with goodies?
Good voicing.
I've none of that. Not a smithereen.
So the Ring City is Wales, is it? Is that what we're taking from this? Oh, she's got items. Fantastic. Split-leaf greatsword. A long-handled greatsword that made its way from a distant land, crafted entirely with steel, making it exceedingly heavy. Split-leaf reverses to the shape of the great blade and its resemblance to the veins of a leaf. Spin weapon vigorously above head and sweep foes, and transition with normal or strong attack for continued spin attacks, which whip up wind and gain momentum, strengthening subsequent attacks. That sounds pretty fun. Do you got anything else? That's all items, isn't it? Yeah.
At the close of the Age of Fire, all lands meet at the end of the earth. Great kingdoms and anemic townships will be one and the same. A great tide of human enterprise, all for naught. That's why I'm so taken by this grand sight. This must be what it's like to be a god.
Ha! So this is one of the pilgrims, right? Which were somehow tied to Londor via Uria. At least it seemed that way, like, because the one we spoke to was directly tied to her. So it's possible that the other pilgrims are also tied to Londor in some way.
Oh, if you just can't stop yourself, at least hear this. Far below, there's a deep, dark hole carved out of a tree. From time to time, voices brim from the depths of the cavity, even now. Mutterings of the very demon that Prince Lorien spoke of, I'm sure. Horrible sounds of an afflicted thing, yet cursing men.
Okay. So we're talking about some horrible thing cursing men. So we're talking, like, maybe Dark Souls stuff? Maybe? Maybe corruption-y, sort of manacy stuff, maybe? Who knows? I can see in your face, it's a hole.
At the close of the age of great kingdom, that this...
This must be what it's like to be a god. I don't know why I didn't check around here. There was obviously going to be something around here. And take the plunge. I wonder if take the plunge is going to be like a theme through this DLC. Leap into the abyss, my friend. See ya. YOLO! Ha! Missed your ring. What do you think of that? Not so cool now, are you? I still kind of want to see what makes that, like, big demon dog thing come up. Because it comes from, like, over here, but I don't know if it's just an enemy. Like, do you make it happen? Does it come from outside? I guess it must come from outside, but I don't know what causes it. Okay, so he casts it. And then that's the end of him? So maybe it's like a, they cast it and then that's it, they're done. Oh, you just appear, that's kind of cool. So we got the ring, so we can kind of just go past this time. Okay, let's go see what's in here. Seems like there's some action going on. Okay, well, there's a load of crouching knights. I'm sure they won't be trouble. This sort of ruined statue. Oh my gosh, look, it's not been eviscerated down the middle. It's kind of gnarly. I'm into that, though. It's cool. So I imagine these dudes will get up, right? Okay, so there's a boy over there, and he's going to buff. Going to buff his mate. Maybe these others won't actually get up. Maybe it's just that dude. Who needs tactics when you've got hyper armor? Yeah, probably should heal. There we go. Gotcha, boy. Okay, these guys don't fight too differently than the old Lothric knights, so I would like to get behind them, to be honest, but oh well. I can break your shield. Don't think I can't break your shield, mate. I think I've got the Night Slayer's ring on. I do have the Night Slayer's ring on. And of course the deep ring for my Karthus Flame Arc that is getting precisely zero use because I don't have it equipped. Maybe I should equip it. I'm not really using the cases. I could just take it off. Ostensibly I had it to parry, but having not played in a while, I don't feel that confident in my parrying skills, so maybe we'll just have the flame arc ready so I can buff up my weapon if needs be. Okay, so these guys not gonna. Oh, it's like the beheading knight from the church, the original like cathedral in Lothric. The sort of the entrance to Lothric Castle, that little kind of abbey. So nothing else going on here. I guess this crypt is going to open or something, because we've got to keep going forward somehow. Yeah. Huh. I mean, that's not what I was expecting. Can we kneel in front of the statue? Like, on top of this dude? Like, Dark Moon Loyalty is not really kneeling, but it is kind of kneeling, I guess. It's not quite what he's doing. Let's have a look, see what we got. None of these are like explicitly kneeling. I always want there to be more gesture stuff. I don't know that there is, but I always want there to be more gesture stuff. No? Give it another couple of seconds and see what happens. Alright. Let's, No? No joy? Did we pick up any other items? We did pick up. Did I look at that thing we got? I don't think we did. I feel like I got something like just after I, before I fought that big boy. Like, I think I picked up a weapon. I might not be able to remember what it is at this point. We'll see. See if I can find something I don't recognize the name of. No. So, but it may not have been a weapon, so that may be why. Do 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 do. Let's quickly check through these. No. No. Huh. Well, if I did pick something up, then I don't know what I did with it. So, I'll have to watch that back later, maybe. Contraption key, that's from the last DLC. Check we haven't got anything obvious down here. No, these are all just old items. Old items. Roster of knights. That's the Darkwing knights. I don't think I've ever actually looked at that. Some rubbish. Nothing leaping out of me. Okay, well, let's keep wandering, I guess. Oh, there's a door here. Well, there, what do you know? What do you know? No, I'm not missing anything else. That doesn't seem like it. Oh. It's like a fountain with another dude on top, another beheaded knight. Yeah, see, that seems to consume them. Unless, like, they respawn over here. Unless he gets back up over here and does it again the other way. Yeah. Doesn't seem like it. It's an interesting mechanic, at least. So you go up or down. The down seems like it's going further out. But then up's going into this building, so... Let's check in this building first. I like the way they do this, where they'll put an enemy like a little way ahead to encourage you to run into the area. And then they put dudes in behind you. Damn it! See, he is kind of dragging me underground. Huh, interesting. But I don't know if that's just slightly dodgy clipping. Wow, these guys keep coming. I mean, they don't, but they sort of, they don't spawn in all at once. I wonder if they're just, I wonder if some of these guys are just respawning. I kind of don't want to just keep fighting them, so that's going to be a hidden wall. This is exactly why, murky longstaff, okay. See, this is why I tend to turn messages off. Because this is going to say, hidden wall. Yeah. And even without reading the message, like, just it simply being there is kind of a giveaway. See, I wonder if these guys are just going to keep coming forever. Oh, Jesus, I've got no health. Let's go upstairs. I guess. Further into this building that I thought might be like a short entrance. See, I wonder if these guys do just keep coming forever. Because it does seem like that. At least in this area. This guy was standing here from the start. I don't know if that makes him special. Maybe he's the one resurrecting them all? They do seem to keep coming back even now, though. So, who can say? Well, I'm sure someone can, because I'm sure someone's done more research than me, but... Onwards we go, up into this, like, dining area, I guess. Is this the, yeah, it is, isn't it? This is the, you can kind of see layouts from the original game, which I always find interesting. So, like, it's not necessarily, like, a reused asset, but, like, they've taken, so this is, like, in Lothric Castle, Great Soul Dregs. So they've taken, there was a room here, and there was, like, a door here. At the start of Lothric Castle, and then this led down to where you find the key, where you get grave at. So this room itself, like the layout of the room, existed before, and they've changed the colour palette, and they've fiddle around with it a bit. I like that. I think that's smart, smart design, you know. Rather, you can only build so many rooms, and also aesthetically it makes sense that the construction is going to be similar across different areas because it's the style of the area, the style of the time that it was constructed in. So it makes sense in fiction. Okay, so we picked up a couple of things there. We picked up the Great Soul Dregs, which is probably here, right? Great Soul Dregs. A dark soul, a sorcery that fires dark, great dark soul dregs that have stewed for ages far within the deep. The sorcery is the highest form of deep soul. Some of the merkmen who rise from the depths are possessed by soul dregs, which have a grave likeness to the human form. Merkmen is a good name. I like that. And we also picked up some other thing, which might be, was it like a chime or something? Murky longstaff, that was it. The long-handled staff wielded by the merkmen who rise from the depths, slathered with a black murkiness, just like me, really, and fit for dark sorceries. Enchant from the depths briefly boosts the strength of dark sorceries, and works in both hands. I wonder how that works. So I wonder if you have it in your left hand, if you have it in your right hand, does it override whatever you're currently holding in your left hand? Because normally, like, if I've got a shield in my left hand and I have a sword in my right hand, it will do the parry, or you know, whatever the shield's special skill happens to be. So I wonder if this overrides that. If it's in your right hand, and there's a ladder here. I see. This just takes us back down there. So that was apparently just a dead end, I guess. Unless there's more here. But I suspect that was a dead end. Like the weird infinite house of dudes. Oh, okay, we can come out here as well. Treasure! Treasure! Probably should have rated that. Oh well. Oh! 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 Now we're talking. I've only got the plus one because I'm not even in the. Actually, this kind of breaks a lot of the. Well, it doesn't actually break that much, but like, you don't need to go and get the plus two from like New Game Plus Plus anymore, because this character I started new just to do the DLC on, in regular new game. And man, look at that. Coveted Silver Serpent Ring 3. Oh, bollocks, I've taken it off. I wanted to look at it. Is that. No, that's 'cause that's no different than the original. But that's cool. And we also got the Ring of Steel Protection plus 3 as well, so interesting. Interesting stuff. And I guess that's it for that room, and then we go down the hill. I wonder if this says like stuff ahead, but treasure. Oh my god, what's going on? Did that fall down? Jeez, that could have landed on someone's head. Tribe, you know, that is good, right? Because it's like, because if you've already been up there, then you know what that means. And if you haven't been up there, it's like, oh, go back for first and go get the stuff. This looks unsafe. But if I walk under the gap, if it splits, it won't land on me, he says. Who are you? I don't have my binoculars on here. Maybe I should. Where are they? They're probably up this end, right? Boop. Boo. That's a weird looking fella. I wonder if we can talk to him or if he's gonna fight us. Oh, it's the bloody angel again. Are you a friend? Are you foe? He doesn't appear to be like. Oh, I can stand inside it. See, that's the thing, it's not causing me any trouble, it's just kind of writhing at the angel. God, you're like a weird slug monster person. Nice. Make some good noises. Jeez, you can shoot over the top of that, can you? Take the plunge. Yeah, there we go, see? Take the plunge again. I'm going to leave that person there. They don't actually seem aggressive, and I'm loath to attack things that aren't aggressive. You know, I always left that dude alive, that kind of baby-faced dude in the prison, in the main game. Oh, God. Ow. And there's pilgrims here, but I... Seems like they're probably all dead. That guy just didn't even make it up the hill. I'm trying to see if the angel's still shooting at us, but it's... He is up there, but it seems like he's leaving us alone for now. Beautiful. These guys not going to keep coming back? It seems very... Oh my god. It's another one of these big boys. And he's come out of the sludge. I woke up. He's having a nice nap. Blimey, crikey. Oh god, I keep... That's such a ruinous combo ender because, like... I'm like, oh, okay, he's finished the combo. I'll just get in there. And you do a swing and he just dodges it by leaping up into the sky. And then just completely, like... Ruffle stomps you with his butt. Oh my gosh. Please, sir. So it seems like two hits will stagger him, which is nice to have because, like... Yeah, see, I can kind of consistently stagger with the second hit, which is... That's really handy. Because it means I don't feel quite as... Oh my gosh. Ugh. That should kill. There we go. Oof. These guys are fun to fight. Kind of a weird area to do it in, though. Like, there's a lot of foliage and bits and bobs up here that kind of get in the way. You know, Dark Souls has always had, like, a little bit of camera trouble, but I feel like that's just... At some point, that's almost unavoidable. I kind of want to walk in this, but I also kind of don't want to... Okay. The angel's slowly rotating. He's like watching me, but he's not actually attacking at the moment. Which is a relief, to be honest. Right, odds on this saying take the plunge. Anyone want to bet? That's more ominous. Take the plunge. You won't die. I'd love it if they just keep going, like, take the plunge, and then they do it once, and then... They should totally add take the plunge as a thing you can write. I don't trust that now. It is a developer message. It would be weird if the developer said you won't die and then explicitly killed you. Can I go on this way? I'm trying to see what's down below. Oh, there's a bonfire down there. Okay. Well, Beefy Boy, it's been a long road. Lovely snowy ground. Here's another ring. The ringed city. I see my instinct is to go over here, which is the wrong direction. Can I get up there? It looks like maybe. I should go to the bonfire first, really. We've come a long way. Woo! Mimic bonfire. Come on, the series is this is ostensibly the conclusion to the series, right? The last DLC of Dark Souls 3. Ah. Just one. The last one in the game. Man, that's what they should do. Like you beat the last boss and then it's just like they give you a bonfire and it just fucking kills you. Well, I guess that kind of is the end of the first Dark Souls and sort of the end of the I guess that's the... Depending on how you finish the game, that kind of is the end of Dark Souls, is the bonfire... The bonfire mucks you up. I want to go over here, because there was sort of stuff over here. I don't know... Okay, you can just walk back up. I thought it'd been weird if they didn't let you wander over here. I wonder if there'll be anything of note. Or if it's just going to be... Hello! How's it going, Rockets? There's some fun geometry. I swear I saw an item over here somewhere. I want to grab it. Oh, there's some mushroom dudes. Hey, mushroom dudes. I wonder if they're just poison ones like in the main game. Just gonna test them out. Yeah, they are gonna be. I wanted to make sure that they were dangerous before I attacked them. Don't want to hurt the NPC mushroom guy who suddenly shows up. I guess they're not really mushrooms. I guess they're kind of like spider crabs that live inside these weird shells. Black fire bombs, very nice. It probably works quite well against those dudes, to be honest. But Okay, well we'll go down, I guess. There may be more stuff we can grab from there, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes. There's an item up there, which is very tempting, and I clearly can't get to. Ooh, there's the angel again. Oh, good. I wonder if you have like good range weapons if you can just kill that guy. Where are we headed? It's the kind of thing, it's like a weird, like, hey, we're going to just force you to go forward faster than you might like. Wow, there's some thieves. Are they being targeted? Yeah, they are. Alright. That's not a normal noise for someone to make. Let's have a look over here. We're not missing out too much. Oh, there we go. I knew it. Can't hide these titanite chunks from me. I kind of wish they'd put something more exciting back here. I feel like I didn't look at one of the items I picked up, but I've forgotten what it was at this point. Ow. It's actually quite awkward to avoid when you're running towards it. I guess you should probably zigzag. Can I get up here? Oh, there's thieves hanging out. Did that guy just jump off the edge? Yeah, okay. Okay. He did, totally did. I guess they've always been doing that, so not really a surprise. Like a weird little... It's weird that they're hanging off the edge of that, given that you can't actually really get into it. See, this is a problem now, because I don't really know where I'm supposed to be going. But I guess we'll head down here. There's a message down there that probably tells me to take the plunge. Ow, ow. Wait, can I hide here? No, I can't. I cannot hide here. That's, Could this be what? Sleep talk? Time for jumping? I mean, I could see it. There was some stuff over there. Go up here first. Oh my gosh, I'm just dead. Wow. Trying to work out where the best way to go is. Okay. Well, we'll keep exploring. This is an interesting idea. It's just like, hey, we're going to put you in this area and this guy's just going to constantly pummel you while you try and work out where to go. How do I get up there as well? Let me go around this way. I don't really fancy my chances of jumping across, so there must be some way to get up on top of the branches. See what happens if we go back up here. If I can, like, run around to the side. Or at least get a better perspective on where we're going. Those dudes jumped down there and they did die. They definitely died, so... Maybe you can just get up like here, I guess. That does seem plausible. Go on then, let's try it. Yeah, I should probably heal up before I get out in amongst it. But I wonder if there's like a way you can just like get up on top of this stuff. Thankfully, this dude doesn't like do a ton of damage every time he hits. But yeah, he's a lot. He really is a lot. Okay, so there's a swamp down here. There are dudes down there, so we can go down there. So this is kind of where we want to be, I guess. Oh, come on. Just gonna tank through that. Doesn't actually protect you as much as I might like it to be honest, but okay, we should be safe here. Let me get a Titanite scale. Wow. That was oh my goodness. It's never ending. Can I get up here? No. Okay. That's fine. What is that noise? I think it might be another angel coming in. Titanite chunks. Let's go see these. Is this going to be like a poison swamp? Yeah, it is. Okay. Not really a surprise, I guess. Desert Pyromancer Skirt. Man, I don't even have my poison stuff on. Oh man, I only have one. I should go buy some poison stuff if we're going to be in a swamp. That's what happens when you play a character you don't really play much, or you only play very briefly. Oh, brilliant. Okay, fantastic. Lovely. Another item over here, which we'll grab. Probably get shot while we're doing so, but I'll take the risk. Desert Pyromancer Gloves. Okay, well, we're getting the set built up. Let's have a look, see what the Desert Pyromancer is all about. Oh, okay. Wow. Don't stand still, apparently. Oh, man. Cursed by an angel. That's kind of cool. Although it's kind of annoying because I would like to have just read the item. Let's see what the item was. No. Desert Pyromancer Gloves. Gloves of the Desert Pyromancers who once walked the halls of the Earthen Peak. It is said that the thin burgundy cloth breathes with magic. Desert Pyromancers, most of them female, were known for their great fans of flame and enchanting looks. Words enchanting can also be deadly, especially when clothed in such alluring garb. Is it particularly alluring? I guess it could be. Where's the, there we go. It's alright, I guess it doesn't seem that alluring, but it's okay. Still don't quite know how you get to this, happy chappy. But clearly you can get onto these branches, because, so if I just stand still now while the angel's around. That's not doing anything, but we are in a different area. Like, if I just stand here, where the angel can't see me. I was going to shoot the other dudes anyway, so... Let's go back over to where I was, because that's a better place to perform experiments. Is there a way I can get across here? Not easily, is there? Oh, there's the curse. There it is. So it's obviously a thing they just kind of put, like, curse stuff on the ground when you're near it. When you're, like, out of their range, I guess. Oh, hang on. My doorbell's ringing. Sorry, I will, I'll have to briefly love you and leave you. And not get cursed, hopefully. I will return shortly. Right, apologies for that. Just got a parcel delivered. Hopefully, we can get back in and we won't be dead. Because we were probably standing in like a terrifying curse pile. Well, that's the way it goes sometimes. Tailbone spear. I wonder if they've added new DLC items to this list. Because my problem with this list is always the kind of thing, it shows items before you get them, and that's weird. Okay, so we were standing in a curse part, curse. So if I just stand still, he should do it, right? Should, like, summon, like, a... Maybe he doesn't know I'm here, because I've technically spawned in here, I guess. So I can run up onto the tree there, I guess. Let's do that. Yeah. This is some, like, this is some proper, like, old school Blight Town great tree stuff. Which it seems to be where this is going, right? There's a hole in a great tree. Jesus. Ring of Favor plus 3, nice. Man, they really don't mess around. Can I go down there? I guess I could. There is a dude down there. There doesn't seem to be anything else on here, but there was a message that someone had left down there. I presume at some point I can take the angels out and then they'll stop being trouble. Oh, dude, okay. Right in his lack of head. That was good. That was quite satisfying. Yeah, I wonder if there's a way to like take all the angels out and then not have to worry about them. Large soul of a weary warrior. Just kick these mushroom men. Oh, that's so satisfying. A monster kill, kill, kill. Now, he was hitting me through the walls a minute ago, but I don't know. I don't know if that's just, like, coincidence and not supposed to really happen. Also, I want to go around the other side, because it seemed like there was stuff around the other side. Hello, hello. Welcome. How's it going? Is there anything over here? Oh, it's just another dude. Hey, dude. I don't want to fight you in this poison nightmare. Ah, oh, fuck it. I'm poisoned now anyway. Come on. Get your booty out here. I gotta be wary of his like weird butt stomps. Come on. Come at me, big boy. I do like his lack of head. Oh wow, that was that was really something. Yeah, get staggered. Yeah, so I've got to remember that he does that after the everything else. I've gotten pretty far. Yeah, I started about 11, so what, are we like coming up on an hour? Or we're just on an hour? But like, I might have missed stuff, I don't know. It's quite possible. It seemed like there were multiple ways you could go in some places. Good lord. Ow! But yeah, we've done quite a bit. We've got a lot of plus three rings so far. A few items here and there. Not learnt too much really. I've only spoken to one person, I think. And she didn't have a ton to say, but she was Welsh. She sounded kind of Welsh. Oh, there was an item there, wasn't there? I should get the item that he was guarding. Given that I went to all that trouble. Can I just run through this? Is this just, yeah, it isn't actually like sticky swamp water. Oh, a tiny slab. That's not helpful at all, but it's a good item to get, I guess. I should go buy some. Next time I'm like in a position to go back to Firelink, I will grab some poison moss. Yeah, we'll find some secrets over time. I found one hidden wall, although it was messaged. I was supposed to play offline and I forgot to turn it to offline, so I'll probably do that when I go for lunch. I should have done it when I just took a break a second ago. I probably should have done it then, but did not think about it. Loincloth! Is that a different loincloth or is it just the same loincloth and it's just a lore loincloth? Ow, ow. God, this dude is relentless. There's another guy there. Oh, I've got to fight him when I'm poisoned as well, because I haven't really got... I mean, there is a slight area that I could be less poisoned, but it's not exactly ideal. The poison doesn't do too much. It's not the end of the world, but... And then the jump, and then down. Ow. There's quite a delay on that and it kind of throws me every time. I'm right in that awkward area where I don't want to heal, but I shouldn't have. That was more kind of a health thing, like I don't want to heal because... You know when you've not really lost quite enough health to heal, but you know if you take another hit, you're going to be almost dead? It's one of those kind of things. Yeah, that move there, it takes so long for him to come down, and it's terrifying. No idea. Harald Curved Greatsword. Hopefully I'm not going to get cursed while I'm doing this. Where are the great swords? Oh, they must be further up. Actually, I guess I was probably... Yeah. Herald curved greatsword, giant gold decorative curved sword wielded by warriors of a Harald legion who sought the Dark Soul. There we go, the Dark Soul. The sword sank into the dark within the with the legion, where the blades were severely corroded. Sever slashed repeatedly at both feet. That's kind of cool. Right, let's not get poisoned again. Titanite chunk. Some thieves over here. See, when I did the last DLC, I was very, very slow in exploring, and I don't know if I want to do that or just kind of get in and see what I can find. That angel's going to shoot at me again, isn't he? Homeward bone! Okay, that wasn't where we were meant to go then. That was just a side zone, I guess. Huh. Can I get down there? Yes, but doesn't really do very much. Okay. Let's get out of the poison. This is where we were a minute ago, I believe. Does seem that way. Huh. Intrigue. Where to go? There's another big dude. Are you just wandering the swamp? That's kind of terrifying. I wonder if he'll come over and fight me. I would love him to. I guess I could try and entice him. Oh my gosh. Huh. I'm gonna go explore over there a bit more, I suppose. But that is kind of where I came from, so... This place is, confusing, which I guess is by design. The problem with this, I haven't really worked out a good way to avoid the hits, and they seem a bit sporadic as to whether they hit you or not. So it kind of... It doesn't feel like I can consistently avoid them, but also it doesn't feel like I'm consistently getting hit by them. So it just feels kind of wonky. Oh, that's going to be the curse light, probably. Right, so there is an item there. Okay, so I should run up here and drop off and grab that item at least. I'm going to get hit again doing this. Ah, if we die, we die. It's not necessarily a huge deal. But... See, look, there was... I don't know why it didn't hit me that time. Oh, bollocks. I don't know why it didn't hit me that time. Like, I don't know what I did differently. There's a trick to the shooting. Yeah, I wonder if there's... I'm sure there is, like, an easy way to get past it and not get hit by it, but... We'll work it out. Like, I can't really tell if he's aiming where I'm going to be, or if he's aiming where I am, or if he's just kind of spamming in my direction. Because it could be some of each. Okay. I still haven't got this item. I still haven't worked out quite how best to get to it. Maybe I should just follow it round. It goes to here. So I only need to get round there. So I should be able to just get to it from here. In theory. Oh, I can probably just jump on this, right? Oh, I can. Oh, there we go. Look at that. That's only a twinkling titanite. No biggie. Alright, I didn't get that item either, so there must be a way to get up on those buildings. Ow. Could you not? I should probably deal with him. Oh my goodness, maybe not. Maybe I should have just left him be. Come on, buddy. Oh, he got killed by the angel. Right, okay. Oh, that seems unnecessary. Does kind of protect me though. So I guess maybe it wasn't entirely unnecessary. Oh, I was going to get the item, wasn't I? Whoa! Oh, I was so eager to get it, I didn't see what it was. You have to tell me what that was if you know. Otherwise, I will look at. I will just have to look through my items. But the thing is, it might just have been an upgrade material or something. I'll have to pause the watch the replay and like just pause it. See what I actually got. Anything happening over here? No. Huh? I'm at a loss. I guess I could go up on here. I didn't go up on here, right? I went round the other way. Can I go over? Yeah, I'll go over here. Turn that chunk. Oh, wow. Is he appearing there or something? Or is he just doing the curse? The weird curse nonsense. Yep, nothing there. Oh, can I not get back up now? That would be annoying. That is annoying. Okay, fine. Fine. I'll play your game. I think I woke that big dude up as well, but he shouldn't be a problem because he's nowhere near us. And I doubt he can maneuver these branches. Well, at least we've been left alone for now. So that's nice. Huh. It's a monster. You know, I'm undecided on those chaps at the moment, so let's not go that far. I guess if you're not using monster as a pejorative and just as a, like, descriptor. Oh my gosh. I didn't see you coming, sir. No, please don't kill me. I'm too young. Too young to die to a goddamn thief. He's much better at navigating this rooftop than me, which I guess is, you know, realistic. Given that it's his rooftop. Then I could go across here, and I could maybe get over to where that dude was. I like this. Again, it kind of like the first DLC, it kind of feels like sort of non-linear in like you can kind of wander around a lot. Yo, dog. Like, do you hurt me? Okay, you do. Alright, in that case I don't feel so bad about killing you. Oh. Okay. So that creates the angel, okay. Good to know. That's probably why they put the other one there. So there was another one of those. A new piece of armor, right, I'll have a quick look. So there was another one of those early on, and it didn't seem particularly aggressive, so I didn't attack it. But obviously it was there to show me that that's how you kill the angels. So. Do we know what kind of armor it was? Let's see if I can. It might have been more desert pyromancer stuff. I had the gloves. Could it be a desert pyromancer like hat, maybe? No. Just more shoes. And I got that loincloth, but that doesn't seem any different than what I already had. And I had the desert pyromancer skirt. Yeah, was it desert pyromancer something? Because I already had 2 pieces of the desert pyromancer set. So I presumed maybe it would be that, but I don't see it. And I already had the gloves and the skirt, so it wasn't either of those. So it must have been... whatever. I'm willing to say that's probably what it was. But... who can say for sure? Well, I'll just have to watch the replay back. And, find out exactly which piece it was. What is this? Got some kind of poison blade. It's like a blood blade. That's fun. Oh god, no! Jesus! I panicked. It might be something else. I already picked up 2 desert pyromancer pieces, and I can't see a third one in my inventory. So I don't know. I don't know. Alright, well, we know where we're going now, so... I kind of want to see if there's a way to get up on that other roof from here. So do those angels come back, or are they... are they magical one time? Oh, hello. An ember. I do like an ember, but it's not... Matt, I'll tell you what, not being quite able to kill those dudes is frustrating. Oh well, never mind. We'll carry on. Ow. Or not. I tell you what, these thieves are still like the most consistently dangerous part. Yep. Oh man. These thieves are consistently still the most like awkward thing to fight. It's just the way they move around. Like, it's really awkward to predict their patterns, I find, compared to like most enemies. Even though they don't do a ton of damage. Yeah. Like, I don't know. I fight big dudes all day, but those little guys just... I don't know. My brain just melts. I'm like, look at him. He's all, like, crawling around. It's like the equivalent of, like, a tiny spider. Those tiny spiders that, like, jump. I just, like, panic because I don't know what to do. I'm like, oh, God, he's jumping around. I want to get across here as well, and I don't really know the best way to do it. And there's a dude here. Just like anime slide past one another. Also, that's the other thing, is that they don't particularly like getting hit by my weapons. Where is that other dude? Is he around the corner? I guess, no, he's there. Okay. That makes my life easier. Right, so we want to go back over here. Huh. You don't come back. Interesting. Oh no, wait, no, maybe you do. No, maybe you don't. Huh. Okay. That is interesting. I kind of want to fight that dude, but also I'm poisoned and I don't want to... none of them have dropped anything so far, so that kind of puts me off bothering to fight him. Are you going to aggro on me if I don't go to you? Probably, right? You probably, like, attack me as soon as I... There we go. Yeah, exactly. Like, the thralls are like... And that dude as well, where he, like, holds his sword up for so long and, like... He just fakes you out and fakes you out. As a pyromancer lady? Is that a pyromancer lady? Looks like it. Pyromancer lady with two thralls. Hello! Desert's pyromancer Zoe. Oh man, that stab kills in one. Yeah, it must have been a counter hit. I didn't think it did that much damage. Oh wow, that's really cool. Oh my god, that does a lot of damage. Wow, okay. I should get a whip. Wow, that's cool. I like that. Fire swords. Oh man, now I'll make a pyromancer. I said this earlier in the game and then I just never... I didn't get very far with it. I just couldn't... There's a lot of cool spells in this game and they just don't feel that potent. But hey, maybe this DLC fixes that. Maybe it does. Okay, so there must be one of those dudes around here then, right? I don't know. Maybe that's crazy talk. But that's what I would think. It'd be like that there would also be one of those dudes around here that's controlling this guy that I can get rid of. Oh well, I guess he's not really posing that much of a problem, so I shouldn't worry too much, but... This would also be easier if I was using, like, a less, like, unwieldy weapon. But, See ya. Okay. I was going to say making some progress, but we're not really making any progress. We're making a little progress. I don't actually need to roll through this. It's not like full on swamp. So I don't know why I am. It's just force of habit. See green stuff, I just want to roll through it. You can't even really see that dude. I think he's like here. There he is. You can just about see his head popping up. But yeah, he's like really awkward to spot. See ya. Hopefully he doesn't run all the way back up. Sometimes they do. Yeah, see, the way he like just keeps running at you with it up in the air is terrifying. I don't know what to do. Should we fight fire with fire? Yeah? Prism stone. Are they? Good thing that she's quite relaxed and then I can take out the thralls a bit more easily. So this isn't actually too dangerous, but it's when you're getting close and she starts doing these fire pyromancies. Oh wow, that did a lot of damage. I think it must have counter hit me. Because I was jump attacking. Interesting. Yeah, this is a... Wow, the whip. This is an interesting new thing to have to fight. Just take it in the face. Ah, my gosh. I mashed the button too hard and got caught in my attack animations. Oh dear. See, first time I tried to just backstab her and got caught out by how wide her attack was. The Dreg Heap. This entire area has just been called the Dreg Heap so far. Right? I think. Yeah, see, I wonder, there's got to be a way to deal with this dude. There's got to be, like, someone over here or something that... Damn. I have to keep fighting these thralls. That's the annoying thing, is I have to keep fighting all these thralls. Everything else is fine. Like running through the poison swamp, not a huge deal. But fighting those thralls, nightmare. There is also a big guy here, but he seems to not show up consistently. There he is. Right, now the question is, if I just do this without waiting for it to go down, can I get up on here? Yeah, I can. Okay. That's good. It's good to know. This has been like the first sort of stumbling block so far. In terms of like a awkward encounter. The thing is, if you try and roll past them the first time, they just keeps coming. Just keeps coming. Okay. Right, let's see if we can get the thralls to come in first. Hope they actually lock onto them and not just... So she's gonna heal. I guess that's only fair, right? Oh my god. I think, like the, when it makes the sort of thicker sound, I think that's when it, kind of staggers you, right? It's like, it does it on the big dragons in Dragon Quest Peak. Like, when you stagger them, it like starts making that sort of thudding sound instead of the regular hit animation. Or the hit sound. Whee! Trying to see if there's anything doing over here, but doesn't seem like it. Oh wow, you can actually just drop down onto there. That's considered safe landing. Interesting. If I go ahead of those dudes, they probably won't catch up to me. He says. There we go. Saved ourselves a little bit of time. Oh. Go fight our nemesis again, I guess. I'm not gonna make that. Gonna have to. Hey, big boy. I wonder if he will come up here. I don't think he actually aggroed, no. They're quite passive, those dudes, until you get, like, right up in their face. Then they're very aggressive, but... until then. It's like, I also wonder if I need to fight this thrall, but I'm still concerned that if I don't, he'll come from behind. Like this one here. Like, if I go fight this dude, is that dude just gonna, like... bonk his way over here and... That's what I would do, if I were a thrall. No, maybe not. Maybe we're okay. I'm determined to take this gosh dang pyromancer out. Oh my goodness! That was one hit. That was all I could do. All three of them. Fireball, stab, stab, fireball. Oh god, watching again on the stream. Oh my goodness. Alright, I'm gonna go get some lunch. And then when I return, we'll put paid to Zoe. So, like, probably half an hour or so, let's say. And I will be back. So, take it easy. And I'll see you very soon.